you hardcore boxing fans out there, how are you doing? It's Big Porky here, the voice of hardcore boxing. I've got a bit of a hangover from yesterday, but shout out to the Hilton International Hotel at Sheffield, thank you very much. And thank you for the big discount. Much appreciated, Lauren. Thank you. Moving on to the show. It was 6-1-1. 6 wins, a draw and a loss. I just want to point out that I did not push for the fight that Keenan Wainwright had. Obviously, lists are given to Dennis and Glyn Rhodes, and obviously it's not my final decision on anything like that, or the kid who drew. So just my opinion before people start having a little pop. I've got the hang on a minute. Here we go. I'll go through it all last night. We did a brief thing last night. We're just finding his feet at Wick Channel at the moment, and there's a few things thrown at us and a few opportunities and that, but it's something obviously we're not experiencing, so we just have to go with flow, don't you, I suppose. But like what we did last night, me and Terry, I think it was only 6 minutes, wasn't it, really? Afterwards, after the show, we just spoke briefly about the main fights. We didn't do them all, but I'm going to go over that now. Let's get my glasses on. Lions of Bat. Keenan Wainwright, lightweight, he got beat by Boris Shukanov. Now, so it goes in it, he fought the wrong fight. He's got a massive punch on him, but there's more to boxing than having a massive punch. He didn't have a plan B. So it's a shame for Keenan that, and I'm gutted for him and his dad Lee. I'm gutted for his family as well, they were devastated. Sufyan Ahmed, super featherweight, he won his fight. Kane Salvin, he's now 3-0. Kane won. But getting back to Keenan, I'm hoping to get an interview with Glyn Rhodes today on telephone. And we'll speak about that. You know, mistakes are made. The guy who dealt with it has apologised, and that's just how it goes, isn't it? Sometimes you can't go in the shower without getting wet, so you can't go in a boxing ring without getting hit, can you? It wasn't nice to see young Keenan getting beat. But going through the rest of them, middleweight Corey Hardy, he drew with Kieran Thomas. Irvin Magno, he won against Michael Isaacs Carrero. Tyrone Nurse beat Oscar Amador. Now Tyrone's now 36-6-2, so he's had 44 fights, Tyrone Nurse, 44 fights, so he's now welterweight, and he'll be looking to have a big fight next. Tommy Frank won, he stopped that John Chua, and good luck to Tommy. We're a late replacement, he were a late replacement for Tommy. mainly because his opponent had visa problems, but getting on to the performance of the night, without a shadow of a doubt, was Josh Whale fighting a kid who were 18-3 and I think 16 knockouts of them, 16 were knocked out. I think I said it was 16 knockouts out of 19 wins. I think it's 18 wins, 16 knockouts. He impressed me, Josh Whale. He looks strong at featherweight. There's people, certain people, and they know who they are, running around saying that Josh Whale is not a featherweight, and he's, you know, he's past his sell-by dates, he's had 40 odd fights. Josh has a clean liver, he's just turned 31, a very clean liver, and I think that, you know, the people that are putting that out don't know that person at all, or don't know him as well as they thought they did. If Josh Whale was on the slide and in danger of getting hurt and shot to bits, as certain people are saying, his dad wouldn't have him in the ring. His dad's been around boxing as long as anybody, you know, Mick Whale wouldn't have him in the ring, would he? So I think that's off the mark. You've just seen what he did to that guy, stopped him in one round. You know what I mean? That's what more can you say? Yeah, opponent wasn't world class, was he? But he wasn't a bum, was he? That's a good win for him, that. So onwards and upwards for Josh Whale. What next for Josh? I don't know. I've heard Gavin McDonald's name mentioned, but they're not going down that route, so I don't know. It's up to Josh's team, isn't it, to decide what they want to do. So, but getting back to the matchmaking part of boxing, if Keenan Wainwright gets up and from being dropped and decks that guy, the matchmaker's a hero, isn't he? But because he's lost, the matchmaker tend to feel guilty, don't they? A bit like the guy who matched Brady's Prescott against Amir Khan. He got a lot of stick, didn't he, the trainer, who Amir had at the time. Now, I can't explain it. Glyn Rhodes will take responsibility for that fight, won't he, because he's the trainer. They've all had to agree on it, haven't they? I think everybody plays a part in it. You've got to be very careful with kids when they're turning pro. You can't. Look at Nasser. Young Nasser, he got beat, didn't he, when Ryan Rhodes were training him, and I don't know what's happening with him now. It can knock your confidence getting a loss that early in your career. But what I will say to Keenan when I see him this week, I'll say, Keenan, Bernard Hopkins got beat on his debut, and he never fought for 16 months. He ended up fighting on his debut, and then he was washing pots in a kitchen, in a hot kitchen in Philadelphia. It was a dishwasher for 16 months. And he were low, but he didn't go back to jail, he stuck at it, and he came back, didn't he, Bernard Hopkins, with a good, and his next loss was Roy Jones when he fought for a world title. So basically, you can come back from it, but I felt for Keenan yesterday, but You know, people, certain people who text me an email and they said, "Oh, you're to blame and all that." No, I'm not. Look, matchmaking is very hard, isn't it? But if you're working with a promoter, you work as a team, don't you? You put a list together, don't you? It's very simple, and you go through them all. Mick Whaley's, for example, he's very thorough. He came to my office in Rotherham, and we were at it 4 or 5 hours going through internet, looking. And you know, eventually, you have to find the right opponent, don't you? Josh Wales just beat a big puncher early doors to stamp his authority in the featherweight division. Josh Wales could be 2 or 3 fights away from a really big fight at featherweight, so good luck to him. Anybody who wants to knock that doesn't understand the struggle that Josh has had to come through in his boxing career at being an away fighter. And a lot of them losses Josh has got, you could half them, really. You could very easily have Josh Whale losing. He could very easily be 36-5, Josh Whale, instead of, you know, what he is at the moment. I forgot where his career is. Oh, is he Josh? Let me have a look. I know Josh, half of Josh's wins, he's knocked him out, hasn't he? So, you know, is Josh Whale is 28 wins and he's knocked 14 out, so he's punching all right, isn't he? You know, you've got 2 draws and 11 losses, but you could easily half them. That could quite easily be 11, 5, 6, 7, 8. Could easily be 36-5, as I've just said. But it isn't, is it? And it's the same with Tyrone Nurse as well. Tyrone Nurse has had some bad decisions. Tyrone Nurse, 36-6-2. 36-6-2. It could quite easily be 42-2. Just that easy. But losses can take confidence out of a fighter, or you could have a knee-jerk reaction. They could blame trainer, blame matchmaker, blame manager, blame promoter, blame everybody. Or they could move up in weight or move down in weight. There's all sorts of knee-jerk reactions to a loss. But sometimes you can just be flat on night. You might need to try new things, you might need a move, you might need a new promoter, new surroundings, new people around you, fresh impetus of ideas, things like that. But it's a very complex game, isn't it? I think. But I enjoyed the show. I enjoyed the show a lot. Now, like I said, anybody who wants to knock it, who works in the boxing industry, go and put your own show on. Go and fork out money for TV companies. Go and pay for an arena. Go sort it all out. Go do what Dennis has done, if you've got a problem with it, and anybody knocking it, go have a go. Too many people are quick to knock it, aren't they? But for a TV show, it was passable for free TV, wasn't it? Free, you don't have to pay for it. Well, that show last night, any better than anything you've seen on Sky Sports this year that's non-pay-per-view? I don't know. Were it any worse? No, I don't think it were. I think it were as good as some of the stuff I've seen on Sky and BT Sport that's non-pay-per-view. But, you know, I enjoyed it, and that's the main thing, isn't it? I got home safe to my family. All the death threats from all the keyboard warriors and daft phone calls. Where were you all? Hey, all you keyboard warriors. You know, Where were all these people on Twitter who, I'll come to the show, where were they? They didn't come, did they? There's talkers and there's cheese and onion walkers, isn't there? So, some people, you know, have other things to do in their life except with the boxing shows though, don't they? They're not all like Karina, are they? Who comes to all shows. She's a nice person, Karina. But, as Frank Smith at Matchroom will tell you, but the main thing is it's July, innit? And it's end of season nearly, so you're not going to get that many people at shows, but, you know, I enjoyed it. And, you know, next show is going to be a bigger one, and, you know, they're all going to be at Ponsford now. So, unless we might throw an odd one in somewhere else. Where, I don't know, that's top secret, I'm not going to say too much. There's a lot of things going on behind the scenes. And, you know, there's only so much I can say on here, but I'm looking forward to next season from September onwards. Should be a good season next season, and hopefully Dennis will get them couple of guys signed in the summer that are coming on board and that are gonna really do well. So, you know, it's all there for Dennis to do now. Get these signings. Get the trainers training the new signings, or if they're gonna come with it, if they're gonna turn pro with the trainer that they've already chose. So it's all good. It's all positive stuff. Onwards and upwards to next weekend now, and is it Amir Khan fight next weekend? Billy Dib. Yui against Samuel Peter, Yui Fury. And there's that Bonza show Frank Warren's got on. Good show that. I think that's a corker. Corker of a non-pay-per-view. So, Frank Warren, I tip my hat to you. I don't normally give you respect. Because let's have it right, Frank. You could put this one on now and then you could give us garbage. Like Tom Swartz, Tyson Fury, that's garbage. You can't say he's Lineal champion and then put Tom Swartz in. Sorry, but no. Jarrell Miller? No. I don't want to see him a drug cheat. One of the worst drug cheats ever. I don't think that sets a good precedent having him back. If he fights Tyson Fury, I will be very disappointed. But I will tip my hat to you, Frank, for your show that you've got on the Gorman DeBar. Joyce Jennings. I think even going down the card, I think that it's 14 fights on. There's only one fighter who's lost, and he's only lost two, hasn't he? And that's, forgot who that is, it's Liam Williams. Liam Williams is the only one who's lost a couple of fights out of their own fighters on the night. So, and that stable Frank Warren's got there. I was looking at it the other day with somebody who shall remain nameless. And we said, that's a good stable that Frank's got there. A very, very good stable indeed. But it's not going to come to fruition for another couple of years. And in the meantime, he's got to get things moving with Tyson Fury, hasn't he, and Billy Joe Saunders, because I'm not saying they're in a crossroad, they're in the at the crossroads of their career, but Billy Joe Saunders, for me, his career is start, stop, start, stop. And for such a mega talented kid, I think that's a shame. I want to see the Callum Smith fight. I think that's a great fight. If it happens or not, I don't know, but I'd like to see that. And I've got Billy Joe Saunders, a big favourite in that fight. I mean, massive favourite, massive. I mean, everybody says Callum Smith's this mega big puncher, but they're talking about him like he's George Foreman-esque, but he isn't. But you know, he's very upright and textbook, and he's like a polished amateur style, isn't he? I think that there's more to come from Callum Smith. He's got this aura about him that he's a very serious fighter, and he's very quiet and that, and the quiet ones are usually the dangerous ones, aren't they? But I'd like to see Callum Smith fight super middleweight guys who've got belts and have unifications, you know, your Billy Joe Saunders, and there's obviously other guys, isn't there, in his division that's really good. So that's what I'd like to see. But it is what it is, isn't it? It's boxing, isn't it? But Frank Warren's stable looks really good. Eddie Hearn's stable, well, without Joshua, he's a bit bare, isn't he? Do you know what I mean? I hope you're alright, Eddie. I hope you like the Viagra, packet of Viagra I sent you. For you, get Frank Smith to try them out. Frank Smith can try them out on Karina. I'm only joking, Frankie boy. I'm only joking. But it is what it is, isn't it? Let's have a look. 21 minutes. Saturday afternoon. I think I'm going to have some more fluids in me, and then I'm probably gonna nip over to the Grazing Hearts at Micklering for some dinner. Billy No Mates. I'm gonna have some dinner, I think, on my own. There's nothing else to do, is there? Fancy a bit of fisherman's pie. It's good for your gastric band, that. It's all mush in it. Yeah, fisherman's pie and more water. Shout out Mark Tibbs, how are you doing, mate? Hope you're alright. Shout out Peter McDonough, nice to speak to you both this week. Good kids, good lads. Hey, Mark used to train Peter McDonough, didn't he, and his dad Jimmy. They're doing well, them, aren't they? Mark and his dad now, Jimmy, doing well. Dillian White looks like he's doing well. He's doing all the massage and sports technology stuff at Loughborough and all that. And I think Dillian's invested in himself. That's good. But he's had opportunities to fight for world titles, Dillian White. And my opinion is this, when opportunity comes knocking, you take the fights. And let me tell you this as well, Dillian White is in a hard fight against Oscar Rivers. That is not a gimme. Alright, now this video is going to go out, and I'm going to say Dillian White wins that fight on points, but don't be surprised if Dillian White loses on points. Don't be surprised, honestly. Or if he gets stopped late on, because Parker nearly stopped him late on, didn't he? He got tired. And Rivers has stopped. Is it Jennings to stop him late on, 12th round? Don't be surprised, because it is, I know it's pay-per-view and that, and I'm not a big fan of pay-per-view. I ain't got nothing against fighters earning, but Dillian's fight, if you take the pay-per-view out of it, you look at it, you say, hey, that's a great Saturday night headliner on a non-pay-per-view. You'd say that's great. So to make it pay-per-view, you've then got to put other great fights on that would maybe not be on Dillian's undercard on it on a non-pay-per-view. So who knows? So I'm trying to give Dillian White benefit of doubt it with the pay-per-view, and I just think that's how boxing's going, isn't it? But it is not a gimme fight. Out of Tom Swartz, Brazil and Rivers and Ruiz, you'd have to say Ruiz is obviously the better fighter now, he's beat Joshua, but before any of them fights took place, we all said Rivers was the best, didn't we? We said, oh, he's the best kid that Dillian's fighting out of the top four guys, because you got Fury, Wilder, Joshua, Dillian White. Dillian's always like the fourth child of it, isn't he? Well, now I think it's all changed now, hasn't it? If Dillian beats Oscar Rivers, you're going to hear Eddie Hearn screaming it. You're going to hear Eddie Hearn screaming. Eddie Hearn will be screaming it from the rafters that, you know, Dillian White's, you know, one of the top guys, and you'd have to say he is, wouldn't you, really? If he beats Rivers, you know, he's gone 10-0 with Mark Tibbs, and I think that's good. I don't see Mark Tibbs doing many interviews. I don't see him pushing himself. There's TV trainers, though, ain't there? We know who they are. We don't need to name them because we're going over old ground. A lot of trainers get a couple of wins and they're all over at TV, aren't they? Now, I think that trainers should be seen and not heard, personally. It's not about the trainer, is it? Too many of them are trying to do the self-promotion thing. Davey Day's all over at telly, he's a manager. He's in every interview, isn't he? Dave Caldwell, same, isn't he? But you think he'd be a bit quiet with LZ's took lately, wouldn't you? But it is what it is, isn't it? It's a tough sport, and anybody who's ever laced up a pair of gloves gets my massive respect. Massive. Whether you're a cock or not. You know, some people are a cock outside the ring. Some aren't. Look at me, I'm a prick, aren't I, most of the time? I'm not a fighter, am I? So nobody's perfect, are they? So, alright. 27 minutes nearly. That's about it. More or less covered it, haven't we? Get some lunch. Quiet in here today. Very quiet. Shout out to all them people who came to the boxing yesterday. It was nice to see Rami. Oh, you're alright, pal. It was nice to see Glyn Rhodes, Sam Sheedy, Tommy Frank, and all them young boxers from SBC. I'm gonna slip that you're in now at the end. Alright, Nicola. There's a video, Nicola, on file. It's only, I don't even think it's a very good picture, but I promised them I'd put it on, but it's going to have to go on at the end of this because it's not long enough to be a video. So I'll just clip it on to end, Nicola. The one with all the SBC, you know, in all the t-shirts from Glyn's gym. Put it all on because they all follow the channel and they're all nice kids. Young Crusher, how are you doing, Crusher? Smallest kid up front, what's your name? Crusher Porky. So, but yeah, so good luck to all them young boxers at Glyn Rhodes Gym. It's a bit of a cult up there now, isn't it? But good luck to them all, and they're all learning off, you know, your Tommy Frank, Sam Sheedy's, John Fuchs. They're all learning, so it's all good, isn't it? But, so, alright. So onwards and upwards. Shout out to Climacool Air Conditioning Company. Thank you very much for your continued support. Shout out to the library. It's the Tappers and Jazz Bar, Atticliffe in Sheffield. Shout out to Justin there at the library. Good man. Good after party, Justin. Really enjoyed it. Good night. Shout out to Terry for coming to the show as well and doing that bit of media work with me. I know it wasn't very long, but you know what the plan was, why we did it, Terry. So, alright. You've got to... We have to get your foot in first before we move on to other things, don't we? So, thank you very much for your time. Alright. Sorry about the delay with videos. I only do scripts and filming. Nicola does the rest, so peace out. keep on trucking, keep supporting boxing. Boom!
Hello all you hardcore boxing fans out there, how are you doing? It's Big Porky here, and I've got with me the Sheffield Boxing Centre guy. What did you think to Tyrone Nurse winning?
Very good.
What do you think to Keenan?
Incredible.
Are you all enjoying yourselves?
Always.
Who's number one in gym?
Me. Ladies and gentlemen, first of all, could you please show your appreciation for both boxers?
What's your name?
Cushion.
After four rounds of action, we go to our referee scorecard. He scores the contest 39 points to 37 points in favour of your winner. From right here in Sheffield, Sufyan Ahmed! Please continue that applause for a gallant